Here with our GoJacks.com volleyball weekly update with head coach Nicole Cirillo. Rough weekend up in Fargo. Take us through Friday night. First off, playing NDSU.
Yeah, overall, just extremely disappointed. You know, I thought that we were prepared. I felt like NDSU was in a very similar spot, and they just came out and outplayed us. And that's extremely disappointing when we're already struggling to finish and have an opportunity kind of within your grasps to just be outplayed. And we didn't know how to respond. And, you know, when you don't respond with matching that level of play, you know, we just lost confidence and lost confidence. And so set one, okay, fine. Set two, we actually played very well. We were up 20-18. We make a rotation error. They turn us back a point to 19-19, and we only scored 1 point from there. You know, that's kind of how our season's been in a nutshell right there is, you know, we're doing well, we make one error, and then we, out of the next 5 points, you know, we gave them 4 of them for them to win the set. And so then you can imagine how set three went, you know, with losing all of that momentum and just not being able to flip that switch back again.
One career accolade from Friday night, though, Maddie Munger returned from injury, recorded her 2,000th career set assist, a neat accomplishment for her.
She needed two. We knew that she needed two from, you know, the middle of last year. And so it was really exciting to see her get those. At one point, after she got, which ended up being her third assist, I looked at her and I said, was that two? And she goes, no, that was 3. And I said, woo, like you made your accomplishment. So, you know, good for her career. And to come right off of injury, you know, and be able to step in and meet that is good for her.
Saturday, it was a tough one up in Grand Forks. Against a quality opponent, they took that one in 3 as well.
Yeah, you know, we knew UND was going to be tough. They're physical, they're big, they have some really good returners. They have some newcomers as well, which is why they've been able to win, but they've went a lot of 5-setters here within the Summit League play. And so, you know, I thought for us not playing very well on Friday, I thought as a team we did a good job of bouncing back, kind of to return to back to where we had been. But, you know, it's concerning that we're kind of stuck in the same spot and that we haven't really moved forward. You know, I felt like during preseason we were continually taking steps. No matter how small or big they were, we were continuing to make progress, and we've kind of been in a rut now really since the beginning of Summit League play. And so, you know, some of that maybe because we've been on the road, and so to get to be home this weekend will be exciting to see how we respond. But, you know, those are excuses. You know, in order for us to turn the corner, we have to be able to take those things and continue to push regardless of the situation of where we're at, you know, and those sort of things.
From a coach's perspective, you know, maybe not players aren't living up to expectations now. What do you need to do to get them back on the right track here?
Our biggest thing is confidence, and I know I talked about this a lot last week, but we have all the pieces. We have the talent. Player for player, I would put my team up against majority of the Summit League. We just don't know how to play, and we don't have the mindset of this is our match. We are going to go out and win. It may not always come out as a win, but you know, again, our struggle has been we compete, and then at the end of sets, we kind of give it away to the other team. And so that's the biggest difference right now, and that's what we have to continue to improve on, is don't be afraid. The worst thing that's going to happen is we're going to lose.
Got a big one on. Actually, you'll have a little bit of time off here, and then Sunday you'll play University of South Dakota. Obviously, a lot on the line with the Corn Cup point and the rivalry there. Preview the Coyotes. They're off to a good start in league play.
Yeah, they're top of the league. They're playing really well. And they're a team that, you know, they lost their 4-year starter setter. So they have a newcomer in. Now, she redshirted last year, so it's maybe not as new. But, you know, there are some pieces that they kind of struggled with early on in the season. They've clearly figured them out. You know, they had some really good wins in preseason. They're clearly on a roll. But I think they're the complete opposite of a little bit of confidence has gone a long way with them. And they're a talented team and all those things that are given when obviously they're at the top of the conference. But that confidence piece and being able to work through things as a team is gonna be tough for us. you know, to be able to fight through and combat.
You'll have another test right after that. It's 4 in 7 days next week, I believe. You'll head down to Oral Roberts. Tough place to play down there, and they're always a very competitive team down in Tulsa.
Yeah, having to travel there midweek is definitely going to be difficult. We play on Sunday, turn around and leave on Monday, play Tuesday, you know, come back on Wednesday since we play at 7 p.m., and then come back right around to play Friday and Sunday again. So it'll definitely be a hard week with that midweek road trip. But, you know, again, it's another opportunity. Everybody has to play on the road. So from a mindset perspective, we have to get over it. That, you know, we're on the road and just go and compete and see what happens. They, I believe they're 0-3 right now as well within the conference. So again, it's another opportunity to take a team that's struggling just like we are. Who's going to put in the work to earn that win? And that's going to be the difference maker in that match.